grace, streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise mine Ebenezer, hither by thy help I'm come. And I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above.
24. My Savior's Love, number 24.
I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder how he could love me, a sinner condemned unclean. How marvelous, how wonderful, when my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. For me it was in the garden he prayed, not my will but thine. He had no tears for his own grief, but sweat drops of blood for mine. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. He took my sins and my sorrows, he made them his very own. He bore the burden to Calvary and suffered and died alone. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. When with the ransom in glory his face I last shall see, 'twill be my joy through the ages to sing of his love for me. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall
We have a selection of songs. The choir has been, it's been 10 years now since we started this. And so what we did for the 10-year anniversary, we went back and we picked out a song from different years. And of course, we added some new ones. There's too many good songs out there to leave out new ones. We did throw in a few new ones there. And so there are a lot of older ones that we sing that we sang years ago. But hopefully it can be a blessing. Let's just bow our heads for word before we continue. God, Father in heaven, we thank you that we can be together this evening, this congregation or this group of people. And as we sing, as we worship together, we pray that you would be honored and you would be lifted up. Father, we just pray your blessing. May each person leave this place encouraged in their walk with you. Ready to face another week. Ready to face the challenges that they have personally. Father, we pray your blessing on the service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you all for having us. It's good to be here with you all tonight. Have you ever thought of giving thanks for just the idea that God speaks to you? You know, some of the songs we sang, there was one song that refers to our hearts are empty They are barren and they're cold, but for the bold hope that he himself planted within, that idea. There's another song that we sang here tonight that refers to our hearts as being desolate. And that is a picture of who we are without Jesus. We have hearts that are cold and they're empty. And I just want to remind myself tonight of the glimpses that God gives to us of his love for us. Just to me, the idea of waking up in the night and there's a verse on my mind or something, that's God speaking to us, I believe. And it's a blessing to rejoice in his goodness to us in providing for us in that way. So throughout the Bible, there are some glimpses of God's love to us. He promised to Adam and Eve after they sinned that he would send a redeemer, and that redeemer would bruise the serpent's head. And that redeemer is Jesus. We see God providing for humanity later on as he called Abraham to himself. And it says in Genesis 15, verse 6, that Abraham believed in God. And God counted Abraham as being righteous. And by the way, his name was Abram at the time that that happened. So I guess I just call him Abraham all the time. So in Exodus chapter 2, verse 25, the children of Israel were in Egypt. And it says there, I think it talks about them being in bondage and they were having a hard time. And it says that God had respect unto these people. And that word can also maybe be translated as knowing. He knew his people. And God knows us today too. He seeks us out and he's longing for us to come to him. So it's a long story, but after all the plagues, they go through the wilderness. God led his children through the wilderness, and they had a pretty hard time there. And I think it's not fair to assume I would do any better than they did. But it says that in Hebrews, they didn't mix faith in their experiences. So they didn't believe God, and God's judgment to them was, you will die. He had them wandering through the wilderness for 40 years, and they were going to die in the wilderness. And we know how God spoke through his children. Later on, there were dark days in Israel's history, but God raised up leaders to show his love to his people. And there was a time in Israel's history, I think it was actually maybe the kingdom of Judah, where God promised to an ungodly king a very familiar verse, or it's the idea of God with us. He said, a virgin shall conceive and bring forth a son. And the first song that we sang tonight gives a little snapshot of that. I think it's verse 2 that refers to God over all, yet God with me. God with me. God with you. He seeks to enter into our hearts and to bless us. Jesus said in John 6, verse 44, the idea that no man comes to the Father except through him. And so we cannot come to God unless he calls out to us. And so one challenge for myself is to give thanks that God speaks to me, that I feel his voice calling to me. And we know it takes a walk of faith. No man has seen God, right? And so we need faith as well. And God demonstrates his goodness, and he gives us snapshots that, yes, he is real. And I think some of that has to do with the thing of him speaking to us through his Spirit, through Jesus saving us. He demonstrated over and over again that He gave everything for us. And I think there's a song that we're going to sing here tonight that says, heaven had no more left to give. There was nothing left to give. He gave it all. He loved us so much. And in God's goodness to us, he invites us to come to him. He says in Matthew 11, verses 28 through 30, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Take my yoke upon you, and I will give you rest. And he seeks for us to lay our burdens on him. We have many burdens in life. We can worry about things that concern us. We all have things that we're concerned about. And the important thing is that we reach out to God and allow him to carry those burdens, sin burdens, things that worry us that may not be sin in and of themselves. We should come to Jesus just and allow him to carry that burden for us. He also gives the Holy Spirit to us. This is a gift that God gives to us. I think it's Luke 11, verse 13, it talks about, and in Matthew there's also a portion where it says, you know, if a child asks of his father a fish, or, you know, will he give him a serpent? You know, some of these kinds of things. Jesus said, if you being evil, you know how to give good things to your children, how much more will my Father give you good things? He gives the Holy Spirit to those who ask him. And I'm blessed when I think of just even the thing of brothers sharing. I heard some thoughts out of Ephesians chapter 3 about verse 20 this morning that were a blessing to me to think about. Thank you, Brother Arlen, for sharing that with us. And God shows his love to us through those around us, too, who are following him. And we also do well, I think in that portion there where it talks about God giving the Holy Spirit to those who ask him, it also says the idea of the Lord's Prayer that forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And so I do well to remember that I can limit God's forgiveness to me if I refuse to forgive those around me, those who have wronged me. If I can't forgive them, I am hurting myself. We are also his sons. God loves us so much. We are not, in a sense, we're his servants, but we are sons. We're adopted into his family. God loves us so much. We are joint heirs with Christ. So I would just like to leave this challenge with myself and with all of you that we give thanks for just the manifestations, however small they may be. Most of life is not extraordinary where God tells you something in the sky. But if we reach out and give thanks for those little nudges that he gives to us, it will be a blessing to you. So may God help us to walk with him. Let's bow our heads to pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you tonight. We thank you for your care over us. Thank you, Lord, that we can worship you together here in song tonight. And I pray, Lord, that each of our hearts would be willing to come to you and to seek you and to find you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Let's sing number 477. Blessed Assurance, 477. Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song,
praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
that way with you, but sometimes there's you hear the song, hear a song for the first time, and you say, we have to sing that one. This next song is for you. It's one of the first times I've heard it. This is one song we want to sing. The message, a powerful message in there, and the message that comes through is that it's not what we have done that we're saved. When we are weak, the power of God is displayed. I'd love for you just to listen to the words of this song. It's a tremendous message.
Jesus, now and ever is mine. dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us.
Rome, our blindness, set us free.
you know it, come up and join us. If you know it halfway, come up and join us. If you want to. They have books up here. Tenors over on this section, we have the sopranos, the altos, and the bass. If you want to join us, come up and join us.
I have been blessed by listening. I would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to the Harmony Mennonite Choir for making the efforts to come out and share this with us and allow God to speak through us, to us through you. And I pray that God would further bless you in this ministry. Apart from that, we have our food committee has prepared a light snack, especially for the choir, but there should be enough for all of you. So you're all welcome to join in with the little snack and some communication. That brings us to the closing of this evening. But I would like to do a little announcement, especially for the home congregation here, and I'll do it in Plotich. Faye Zinda Zedek Tatavir, the agenda is Nehrajikuma for the marriage seminar with Van Deeper Life Ministries Upchamt. They would have sent a Fandos Morning Sabir to Akarajivast. China had on Yedacht on that Waiter Lotus, so they sent a Nunach Hinge Banner when Inkwe interessiert ein to name. They sent for sure for Yira family here in Edental ain't available. And for you and Andre, what that would have liked to sign up. Okay, let's bow our heads for our closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the beautiful, blessed evening that you have given us here. We thank you that there are so many workers for you, allowing you to work through them and speak through them. We pray that you would bless all of us here and help us to live what we have heard. Be a light to your honor and glory. We pray your blessing on all of us as we part, in your name, amen. We'll dismiss. One more song?
Thank you, sir. I didn't see the food yet, but we'll say thank you.